Hi and hello all. Let us have a look at Beckmann rearrangement. In Beckmann rearrangement, an oxime gets converted into an amide in presence of an acid. This could be a Bronsted acid or it could be a Lewis acid. This OH leaves and this R group migrates to this nitrogen, resulting in a carbocation, which is on reaction with the water will yield this amide. Now, this need not to be an OH group. It could be a good leaving group, like a tosyl group. Now, one interesting factor about this reaction, this R group migrates to this nitrogen. The R dash does not migrate. For the migration to happen, the leaving group and the migrating group has to be on the opposite sides of this pi system. So, the migrating group has to have an interaction with the antibonding molecular orbital here. So this bond sigma star is here and this R will interact with that sigma star. So as they are on the same side, R migrates. Now let's have a look at the mechanism of Beckmann rearrangement. This OH picks up this proton, this two electrons, this lone pair is going to stay in between this oxygen and this hydrogen. That means there is going to be a new bond here that we can represent with the curved arrow like this. This OH bonded with the hydrogen and there are three bonds on this oxygen and the oxygen will have a plus charge. Now this could leave as water, that's minus H2O we have shown here. So this could leave as water. So this bond could break, the two electrons here will be on oxygen. That will become the lone pair in oxygen. So nitrogen will lose an electron. So nitrogen is getting electron deficient. So this R group migrates here to this nitrogen. So let us show that with curved arrows. So this is this group leaving and this is the migration here. Now this R group with its electrons migrates to this nitrogen. In this bond, one electron belongs to this R group and one electron belongs to this carbon. So the maximum probability of finding these electrons are not going to be here in between this carbon and this R. Rather, it's going to be in between this nitrogen and this R. That is represented by this curved arrow. That means this carbon lost one of its electrons. So there will be a positive charge on this carbon after the changes represented by this curved arrows. So the R group migrated here and there is a plus charge on this carbon. And this has a resonance structure. There is a lone pair on this nitrogen and that can stabilize this positive charge or this carbocation. So we can write a resonance structure like this. One more thing to remember about the migration. The group which is trans to the leaving group migrates. So in this case, R group migrates, R dash never migrates. This is the carbocation and this is the resonance structure. Let's show the addition of water to this carbocation. So that's what happens. Then in the next step, water comes into play. So this has a lone pair of electron and this will attack this carbocation. So let's show it like that. That means these two electrons are going to stay in between this carbon and this oxygen. So there won't be any plus charge on this one and there will be a plus charge on oxygen as it's losing one electron. So now there is a positive charge on oxygen. There is a new bond here. There is no charge on this carbon. It doesn't matter whether this H2O, this water molecule adds here on this side or on this side because as the double bond won't be there, and this stereochemistry won't be relevant later. So we won't worry about that now. This can undergo deprotonation like this. And another water molecule can pick up this H+, and the two electrons in this bond will be on oxygen. So the maximum probability of finding these two electrons is going to be on this oxygen, not in between oxygen and this hydrogen. Okay. After deprotonation, we will have a structure like this. Have a look at this structure. There is a double bond and on this carbon, there is an OH. This could undergo tautomerism. That means this hydrogen is going to be on this nitrogen and there will be a double bond between this oxygen and this carbon and this double bond won't be there. Okay. So this is the amide as a result of Beckmann rearrangement. Let us have a quick look at the rearrangement mechanism once again. So oxime OH could pick up this proton and this will become H2O plus, which is a good leaving group. It leaves and the migration happens. The trans to this leaving group, the group which is trans to the leaving group migrates, that is R migrates, R dash does not migrate. And then we will have a carbocation like this, which is resonance stabilized. And to this carbocation, water is getting added here. And then there will be bonded like this, and deprotonation happens, which leads to this structure, which on tautomerization, we get the product amide. An oxime will get converted into an amide. This is a ketoxime. Aldoxime does not give a high yield for this reaction. Aldoxime means one of this R or R dash has to be H. Let me show you an example of this reaction. Probably the most important example is the preparation of caprolactam, which is a precursor for a nylon 6. Hydroxylamine reacts with ketone to form oxime, a ketoxime. This ketoxime is the precursor for our Beckmann rearrangement. Adding sulfuric acid to this, so this becomes H3O plus, a good leaving group. It leaves, and the group opposite to this is migrates. So this part migrates. So this happens. So let us copy this down and try to make sense of the curved arrows. So this means this bond is no longer here. This migrates to the nitrogen. So this is forming, and there will be a carbocation formation here. Accordingly, the water eliminates, of course, during that time, water eliminates. So you'll have a structure like this. So this is the carbocation. Okay. Now deprotonation can happen. Another water molecule can pick up this proton. Or a base has to be added to the reaction mixture. Now, this could undergo tautomerization and form the lactam. After tautomerization, this will be this lactam. This is known as caprolactam. Cyclic amides are known as lactam. So this is a cyclic amide. This one is caprolactam. Migratory aptitude of some groups in this, for this Beckmann rearrangement. That means if it is a phenyl group, if this R group is a phenyl group, this reaction, this rearrangement happens pretty fast, faster than if it is a methyl group. So migratory aptitude is usually goes from phenyl, then tertiary, then secondary, then primary carbon atoms, and last one is CH3 methyl group. So this reaction will be faster, that is, this phenyl group will migrate here, and this reaction will be slower, simply because this phenyl group stabilizes the charge, develops in this moiety during migration. We could think of a transition state like this. So this positive charge developing here is better stabilized by this group, and usually bigger the group, better is the stabilization of the charge developed on that group. So phenyl group migrates better or faster than methyl group. So let us see a special case related to Beckmann rearrangement, Beckmann fragmentation. Consider a species like this. This is the normal migration can happen, normal Beckmann rearrangement. But this particular group is a tertiary butyl group. This can stabilize the positive charge developing here. So when it undergoes Beckmann rearrangement, let us see the mechanism. There is a slight difference. There is a difference in the mechanism. So let us explore that. So it goes as the usual. So the OH picks up H plus and it becomes a better leaving group. So it leaves. But look here, this bond, these two electrons are going to stay in between this nitrogen and this carbon. Usually the whole thing migrates to nitrogen. Here, this does not happen, but this bond forms here. That means C triple bond N forms here. And this will become a carbocation. Let us copy the whole thing down and try to make sense of the curved arrows. So here this bond is breaking. That means this is leaving as water. So there is no H here. That's autocorrection. So water leaves at the same time. This breaks apart and that forms a bond here. So the autocorrection H is got removed now. So that's fine.
And now this is a C triple bond N, or N simple bond triple N triple bond C, and so it has to be linear. So let us make it. So this has to be linear. Let us make it linear. Okay. Now what happens to this one? This part, you know, this carbon lost one of its electrons, so that carbon will get a positive charge. Okay, so all these three species forms. There is a lone pair on this nitrogen that could attack this carbocation. So this arrow, this curved arrow means there is going to be a new bond between this nitrogen and this carbon. So there will not be any positive charge on this carbon, but the positive charge will be on nitrogen. Obviously, this has a resonance structure we can write. Okay, so we have a resonance structure like this, and we can show the addition of water to it. This arrow means there is going to be a new bond between this oxygen and this carbon, and the positive charge is no longer on the carbon. So this happens. So it goes according to the Beckmann rearrangement only. So let us copy this whole thing down and try to make sense of the curved arrows, but it is on oxygen. Now simply a deprotonation. So H plus leaves, and you have a structure like this. This will undergo tautomerization and form the amide. So this product is basically Beckmann rearrangement product only. But so anyway, this reaction where a nitrile group is, where a nitrile group is reacting with a carbocation is known. This particular reaction is called a Richter reaction. So basically after this fragmentation, what happens is a Richter reaction. So if this migrating group is a tertiary butyl group or groups like that, which can stabilize the positive charge very well, then the fragmentation can happen. This carbocation can form. With that, the nitrile group will form and the reaction will go on to form an amide. Again, this is basically a Richter reaction. So that is about Beckmann fragmentation. It could do this particular tertiary butyl group or any group like this, where if there is a phenyl group, it's even more stabilized. So all these reactions, this fragmentation will happen in species like this. Okay. Hope you understood what is Beckmann rearrangement and its mechanism. Thank you.